This is what the standard Isuzu exhaust looks like. Four cylinder, that was on there like that, then had the exhaust pipe going down. And our upgrade is this bad boy over here. That's how that goes on there. And this is our water cool system. It's hopefully going to keep the engine compartment nice and cold and going to last at least 20 years. Ricky guaranteed.
She was old and neglected, so we cut her two bare holes and built her up from the ground with our blood, sweat and tears.
So follow our journey as we plan to sail her to new destinations and make lasting memories.
Like a glove, man. This one goes.
We had to ensure that the exhaust parts did fit before we assembled it to get welded.
So here's what the exhaust manifold is going to look like on the inside of the cooling jacket. So that's how it lines up. It's just roughly lined up. That everything's going to get welded, and those get welded around the lip there, and then the joining one goes underneath there, and then just flips over and goes into this housing where it will be water cooled.
So just to give you a basic understanding of how we're going to mount the exhaust, that's inlet and outlet of the water that's feeding into the exhaust system, and the exhaust system pretty much mounts like that, and so that's all baffled up, keeps all that warm air in there, or the heat from the exhaust gets channeled, transferred into the salt water, and then that goes down into a mixing elbow that comes at the end. That's how it started out, and as we start welding, we got Marcus, the guy that helped us out with building stainless steel stuff for the boat. He's gonna do all the welding on this because we need someone that can do good welding on stainless steel. We don't want to have any leaks, because if it leaks from here, it will go into the exhaust ports, and then obviously we'll have some serious damages like what we had on the previous engine. That's our Isuzu that we're gonna stick into the boat. So a little pickup bucky engine going into our sailboat.
It's about what, like 7-8 o'clock at night. We're just finalizing the markings on this. And there's the, so that's inside, that's gonna be inside the enclosed cavity, and then those connectors go on there, which directly onto the manifold, and takes this in place. So that's pretty much how it's going to look. So we'll have that enclosed in the water jacket. That's going to be open, and we're going to put our exhaust studs on there. So there we go, and then we just close it in. Everything's marked up, ready for Marcus to weld it up for us. So that's pretty much what the, once the box is closed on, that's what the exhaust is going to look like. And we'll take in water on the bottom side, out on the top side, and then fix into the mixing jacket, and there's the fittings that are going to go on there. We actually just took some standard 316 fittings, cut off the thread at the bottom, and place it on there, and weld it up. And there's the mixing jacket, or the mixing elbow. And we've just got one more of these that we've cut down, and that's going to go inside there as the mixing elbow.
This is our setup by Marcus. Marcus started welding up everything for us, and we're just going over the second double check, just make sure that everything's perfect. But that's pretty much our exhaust manifold, how it's going to be. All of that's together, goes in there nicely, takes these spaces in between them. Then take the end plate that mounts onto the engine there, and then that one will go onto there with our mixing elbow that Marcus will make afterwards. And then Marcus also adding an anode in there so that we can avoid corrosion. Yeah, that's awesome. And you got the man behind it? There's Marcus. Awesome.
Marcus comes bearing gifts.
Check it out.
Holy moly. And there's our water-cooled exhaust, all done up. Man, it's so well done.
So we're here at John Dirker at the moment. These are the guys that built our engine. And Arno said to me when we're done building the stuff and we needed to face off some of the things, we can bring it here. And that's what, exactly what it is. Our exhaust has been welded up and milled up. We did some of the drawing in the previous episode. If you didn't catch that, check that out. And now what they're doing is they're busy taking off layers. So they're starting with a very thin layer. They're seeing where's the warp from the weld. And then they'll just take layer by layer until they get the last layer. Then they'll change the bits and do that last smooth cut with it. I mean, having guys like this around here and going to an engineering shop is available anywhere in the world for the most part of it. I suppose more the third world countries will struggle a little bit more. But in the bigger cities, you kind of get these guys and you send the work to them and they get it done right. Especially things like this, you need to spend a lot of money to try and get the same quality that these guys are going to do. So just send it to them, let them do it for you, and then get it back and then you got it. Never stop the way, yeah. Birds jumping and I hear my name, grasping into a life. Life is happy but it's so insane. We must merely make it. So this is the exhaust that we used to have on our engine. So this is the exhaust manifold, and what it does is from each cylinder the exhaust gases go into there, and then it goes down there and down the long length and comes out your exhaust pipe through a couple of baffles or whatnot. And now with this, well, the problem with this on a boat is that this gets extremely hot and this radiates heat into the cabin or to wherever the engine's mounted. Not only does it do that, it also creates a hot spot so that if something had to spill on it, it's probability of a fire. So to reduce that, we build a wet exhaust, which basically means just taking the normal exhaust and putting a casing around it that you can water cool. So it would water cool the outside of the manifold, bring the temperature down, and a little bit also improve on the amount of noise that it makes. So you get a quieter running engine, be cooler running, so when you open the engine bay, it wouldn't be as hot as a normal car's engine, for example. So what we build is water-cooled exhaust. So this is our water-cooled exhaust. If you haven't checked when we drew the plans, I think it's in one of the previous episodes, we drew the plans for it. And then we got all the components built inside, built the internals, which look like that other exhaust, similar. And then we put a casing around it. And this casing is where water comes in. So we've got a feed line of water comes in at the bottom and water goes out at the top. And then that water goes over the top of the exhaust and goes down to this end and mixes into the mixing elbow. Because we're above the water line, we can mix direct. We don't need to run it through an anti-siphon unit and then into the mixing phase. So the mixing phase is just that piece that attaches to the end of the exhaust. It's still part of the exhaust, but attaches to the end. And then the water that goes through the heat, through this outer casing, cooling down the exhaust system itself, gets mixed directly in with the exhaust gases itself. So lowering the exhaust gases, diesel engines can get up to 600 degrees Celsius EGT, so exhaust gas temperatures, 600 degrees Celsius, and by bringing that all the way down to around about 50, 60 degrees Celsius is what the ideal kind of setup is. You want to bring it all the way down, so when it comes out of your boat, it's literally at 50, 60 degrees Celsius, and that would be perfect, reducing all that amount of heat out of the system, making it a lot cooler, better to run. There's no steaming everywhere. Also mixes up a little bit of the soot, mixes up with the water, and then comes out in the water. The particular one that we built, let me run you through it, it's four cylinder. We got a four cylinder engine, and so there's our four cylinders, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then they come here and they mix into a main line. So what we've done is directly from the intake of the exhaust manifold, we've expanded it substantially. And the only reason we did that for is to not have any restrictions on the system. So it expands and then it runs into a bigger pipe immediately, and that's what comes out. So that's already the standard size for this exhaust on a vehicle. So that's the standard diameter of what this one would be. See the intakes? much smaller. See the outlets, that outlet much bigger. And now from here it expands again to a 76 millimeter diameter as per the calculation for exhaust expansion diameters, and you can find that in the Vitas manual if you guys want to check it out. So there's a calculation there, and you can check it out exactly how they work. It's a really simple formula, but if you don't understand how they derive the formula, don't worry about that. Just stick in your values in there, and you'll get exactly what you want and what size diameter you should be running for yours. So yeah, mixing elbow bolts onto here, and the reason we haven't built ours yet is because we're going to fit it on the engine, see exactly how it lines up, which direction we want the mixing elbow to run, and how we're going to turn it before we get it welded up. Marcus, as we saw in the episode, he did all the welding for us. He did a beautiful job. I think it's an amazing job. And in addition to that, I had him add an anode. So I went to go buy the anode, one of these kind of ones. This is actually for the commercial guys. They use it on the squid boats and a whole bunch of other commercial applications. And I saw this there in the store, and I was like, that would be a perfect anode to use in my exhaust system. So I put it on. I just got a standard stainless steel fitting, and then I'll just put some tape and just isolate this brass off from the stainless. But that's it, and I can monitor this. So every couple of hundred hours when I do the services, I'll pull this one out, I'll check what's the condition, and that will tell me, is it working, isn't it working, what's happening inside the exhaust. Because what you want to remember is that salt water is extremely corrosive, especially in an environment that there's so heated environment like what we have here. There's a lot of conductivity going on, so you want a sacrificial piece, and that's what this is. It's an anode. Anode is a material that we're willing to sacrifice. So we sacrifice this material, and that will deteriorate over time to save the material that our part is made out of. So that's the basics of an anode. You get a whole bunch of anodes made out of different materials. Some are aluminium, zinc. I believe this is a zinc anode. And yeah, so that's what this anode's purpose is. So in building it, Marcus welded everything. He welded the top, and then we took it to John Durka, as you guys saw, and we skimmed the face. And that's to allow us to get a perfectly flat face, so that when it mates on here, there is no space between the two. You're not kind of trying to twist the exhaust. If you put it on directly after you had welded it, you would notice that you'd actually kind of try and pull the exhaust to straighten out. It's naturally like, it's just what happens with metal and when you weld them, if you don't know, for the guys that do not know. And so by skimming it with that machine, they used actually a mill, and then they ran it off it with a facing machine, I believe.
Hey, Tommy.
How's that for a fit?
Looks good.
Now that's why they skim it, to get it perfect like that. And now what we're going to do, in addition to the cooling function that we're going to get out of there, is I'm going to wrap all of these in fiberglass.
Why?
So that's what I'm going to say now, hun. So in motorcycles, you wrap the header pipes to more like fat boys, and that you wrap the header pipes in some fiberglass to reduce the amount of heat coming over your leg. So what we're going to do is just fat wrap this. We're going to put as much wraps as we can on each one of these pipes to reduce that heat. But that's what the heat exchange, that's what the water cooled exhaust looks like, pretty much, on our model. Let's show you guys what the engine looks like. See?
No,
we get around this way. No, we're not going to paint it. It looks sexy. We're going to put our signature on it.
Oh, that'd be cool.
I haven't got much space over here. So what we're probably going to do is bend it over here, put the bend, take it out there, run it to the front of the engine, put the exhaust box in the front, and then bring it around this side and out of the boat on this side. So that's the initial plan. We'll still see how it goes, but all I know is that it's looking freaking awesome. Check it out. We dropped off all the parts from the engine today, and this is our water pump that we got. So it's a good quality water pump. These things are like $300, $350. So we're going to reuse it. You need to make a couple of spaces. There's one that's broken. Got a piece of material that I'm going to make it out of, and an end cap that experienced some heat. Some new bearings to go in there. So I just popped down to the local bearing store, some bearing man. Got some bearings for there.
And so we need to turn one of these into a spacer part that holds a seal inside there. So we've got a piece to start off with, and now we'll take our... So now we're going to turn them into one end cap and one spacer. So you can see inside there, that's the, it's like a spacer that holds the seal that goes there. So I just got to recess that a little bit, right up to about there. And then that's going to hold the seal in place that goes inside there, so that the seal doesn't move. Almost perfect. Getting everything lubricated. Bearing, some waterproof grease. Putting some grease on the impeller, some marine grease. This is for the startup and to make it easy to go in so that we don't twist or damage any of the vanes. Those little things are known as vanes. The impeller. Taking the persuasion tool at the pump. So there we got a pump rebuilt now. So we got a new shaft seal, two new bearings, new impeller, plenty of grease. She's ready to rock and roll. And we got some extra shaft seals and some extra bearings to take with us, just in case.
Stay tuned till next week as we continue finishing up our engine and stern drive. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe below if you haven't already and give us a big thumbs up. If you'd like to join our amazing patron family and support our production, or just like to buy a t-shirt or make a one-swift donation, you can do so by clicking on the links below. Thanks to our awesome new patrons, John Salter and Fernando da Costa.